dear children, in today's English class, I am going to discuss about analytical paragraph writing. As you are already aware that CBSE has introduced writing analytical paragraph as a part of the revised curriculum under the writing section. First of all, you should know what is an analytical paragraph writing. Analytical paragraph writing, it is a form of descriptive writing which is written on the basis of a given chart, graph, data, outline, clues, table, etc. When writing an analytical paragraph, one should remember to describe the facts in the best possible manner and to cover the information provided. The analytical paragraph has to be written in around 100 to 120 words. And dear children, this question will come in your board exam for 5 marks. So the paragraph must use clear and crisp language along with providing complete details of the chart given in the question. There will be an internal choice given. You need to attempt one question out of the two questions of analytical paragraphs given as a choice. The question carries 5 marks. It means two analytical paragraph based questions you will get in exam. Out of these two, you have to select one, and this question carries 5 marks. Now we will learn how to write. What are the important features of an analytical paragraph writing? Number 1, it describes the given chart, table, data, graph, clues, etc. It should be brief and comprehensive, include complete information at the same time. Number 3, it should state facts that are provided by the chart. 4, it is necessary to make use of simple and accurate language. 5th, it should mention figures and quantities appropriately. 6, it is appropriate to use the same tense throughout the analytical paragraph. 7, no personal observation or response should be provided. This is very important to note down. 8, it would be preferable to use the passive form of the verb. Now, analytical paragraph writing format. An analytical paragraph shall be divided into 3 parts: introduction, body of the paragraph, and conclusion. And as far as the format is concerned, introduction, explain in 1 or 2 lines the subject of the graph or whatever picture given. Because 100 to, I have already discussed you about the word limit 100 to 120. So when you have to write this analytical paragraph in 100 to 120, so it should not be very long, but all the aspects of analytical paragraph it should cover. So introduction will have merely 1 or 2 lines. Then body of the paragraph. Explain in details what the graph is about. Use relevant figures, explain trends, make comparisons and contrasts. Divide into sub-paragraphs if required. Then at last conclusion will come. Conclude the paragraph giving the overall view or summary of the graph. Let's discuss each of these in detail. Now, 3 paragraphs will be there. Now we are discussing all the 3 paragraphs in detail. Number 1, the introduction. The introduction is the first paragraph that should describe in brief what the graph is about. It should be like an opening paragraph that introduces the reader to the context of the chart given. When writing the introductory paragraph, you need not go into the details. You just need to mention what is clearly evident from the chart or the graph given in the question. it is best to write the introduction in one or two lines. Number two, the body of the paragraph. This part of the analytical paragraph should contain details of the graph, chart given in the question. It should contain all the important information. It is extremely important to choose the significant details that should be included in the paragraph. The body can be broken into two or three sub-paragraphs depending on the information extracted from the graph. Breaking the body into sub-paragraphs makes it easy for the reader to understand, but it entirely depends on the given content. Now, and at last, there will be conclusion, which we have discussed here. Conclusion will also be there. It will consist in third paragraph. Now we will do one question, example question. The pie chart shows the proportion of people from different households living in poverty in the UK in 2002. Write an analytical paragraph to describe the information in 100 to 120 words. Proportion of people from each household type living in poverty. See, you can see one pie chart is given. Single aged person is shown with blue color, aged couple with red. You can see this description also. In how the things are described in this pie chart. Now, on the basis of that, we are going to complete this question. The given pie chart, you can see first two lines or two and half lines are the introduction one. The given pie chart illustrates seven different categories of household living in poverty in the UK in 2002. Now, main body of paragraph starts. As you used to do in your article writing question, exactly the same way you have to continue, but here the word limit is limited than that of article writing. It is clearly evident from the pie chart that 26% of the total poverty-stricken households are those of sole parents. Single people without children account for the second highest proportion with 24%. In contrast to couples without children, that accounts for just 9%. Couples with children account for 15% of the poor households. Single aged person and aged couples proportion for 12% together for poor households. Overall, 14% of all households in the UK were living under poverty. The younger generation had a greater poor percentage than their aged counterparts. Couples without children had better economic conditions than those with children. So this is the example of analytical paragraph which is solved because of the help of this pie chart. All the things are given and these things you have discussed in your questions answer. Three paragraphs are there. Introductory para, you can see. Introductory paragraph, then main body of paragraph starts with, finishes here. Thank you, everyone.